हेलो एवरीबॉडी, ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेलकम इन इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे एज यूजुअल यू आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ पोएम दैट इज पाइड ब्यूटी, कंपोज बाय वन ऑफ द फेमस विक्टोरियन राइटर जेरार्ड मैनली हपकिन। पाइड ब्यूटी, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट ब्रीफली अबाउट द पोएट। Gerard Manley Hopkins was born in 1844 and died in 1889. Professionally, he was poet, academician, and just priest. Some of his important work: The Snipolar, Windhover, The Wreck of the Just Land. He was famous Victorian poet, especially his show. Popular became so popular because of his style of writing, sprung rhyme, and use of different imagery. His main theme, generally he writes about nature and religion. Okay, now you can see his poem, Pied Beauty. Actually, I'm not gonna read all the poem, just beginning. Glory be to God for dapples thing, for skies of couple color as branded cows. Now, this first sentence give the total essence of the poetry, total essence of the poem. Glory be to God for dapples thing. He glorifies God. He prays God for the beautiful, wonderful, colorful creation of the world. Okay, please, you go through the line yourself. Let's talk about the theme of the poem. Yes, the first line is the theme. It is Cottle's sonnet because it has only 10 and half line sonnet. He expresses his cheerful mood in the country of Wales. Okay, the most important thing what he want to convey is that he expresses the glory to the God who is such a creator, edge creator of colorful world. He highly appreciate. Now let's go to the interpretation part of the poem. Multiple creation and the colors are highly glorifies the beautiful creation of the God. He highly appreciate the beautiful creation of the God. That is the main theme of the poem. He highly appreciates the multiple color of the sky. Though we say that blue sky, however, in different situation, the sky reflects different color. In the evening, in the mornings, in the cloudy times, of course, you know, we can see the multiple color in the sky. Clouds are compared with the brand scouts. And colorful flowers, he talks about the beautiful multiple colors of the flowers, and he talks about the multiple colorful spot on the body of a trout, a kind of fish. He also talk about the chestnut. He compares the chestnut, that fallen chestnut, with the fresh fire coal, the burning red. He also talk about the beautiful colors of varieties of birds, and he talk about the earth with beautiful landscape, varieties of landscape, multiple colors of the landscape, structure of the landscape, either that can be okay plotted or the fallows. You talk even talk about difference of the people involved in the different occupation. Some are fishing, some are sailing, some are making cloth. That variety, all the thing on earth have their own importance. Such a multiple thing, they of course have their own importance and their own unique beauty. Flickers, placards have the unique or comparable beauty, whatever they are, constants or the flickerings, they are absolutely beautiful of their own uniqueness. Everything has their own motion, taste, and luminous intensity. They are absolutely unique. swift or slow, sweet or sour, dazzle or dim. Such a wonderful creation of the God. That's why we must praise the wonderful creator of the beautiful words, means we should of course praise the God for his beautiful creation. That's what he expressed in his poem. Okay, thank you very much for your listening.